SmartBench needs to be homed and squared before it can do anything else. So it's important that you understand what these procedures are and how to carry them out. Now, homing and squaring are separate procedures, but they do affect each other and often need to be carried out together. In this video, we'll take you through the key principles of both and how to carry them out. So first of all, what is homing? Homing is an essential operation that SmartBench has to carry out to find its limits to set up its coordinate system in the X, Y, and Z axes. Once SmartBench is homed, it will use this position to reference all of its movements against. SmartBench will always home in this corner. So next, what is squaring? Squaring is a process in which SmartBench's X axis is made perpendicular to the Y axis. So how do I home and square SmartBench? Homing is an automated procedure that SmartBench will carry out itself. And squaring, you've got two options. You can either do it manually or SmartBench can automatically do this as well. We'll go into more detail on these in the following sections. So now we're going to show you how to home with manual squaring. Manual squaring is done before we power the machine on. The main advantage of manual squaring is that it can be more precise and puts less stress on the motors. So with SmartBench powered off, the first stage for manual squaring is to remove the extractor hose from the Z-head. Next, we need to move the X-beam until it hits the legs. To do this, hold the middle of the lower X-beam and pull it towards the home end. You need to ensure that the lower X-beam is contacting the legs on both sides. Now that we've squared the X-beam against the legs, it's time to power on SmartBench to lock the motors in position. After booting up, the Z-head will light up yellow and the console will display the safety warning screen. So when SmartBench is booted, I can read through the safety screen and clear it when I'm happy, and it will bring up this pop-up. In this instance, I can select, no, I manually squared already, and then press the home button to start the homing procedure. SmartBench has now been manually squared and it's gone through the homing cycle, so you're ready to get on with your job. So now we're going to show you how to use the auto squaring feature on SmartBench. Auto squaring is the fastest and easiest way to square SmartBench. The operator simply needs to press a button on the console and SmartBench will square itself by driving the X-beam against the legs of the Y-bench. This squares SmartBench more approximately and is less precise than manual squaring. However, it is often fine for general non-precision work. So the first step to auto-squaring is to power on your SmartBench. Now at this stage, it's worth noting that it doesn't matter what position your SmartBench is in, it doesn't need to be against the legs as it does with manual squaring. So to power on, just twist the power button and release. Once SmartBench is booted, again, read through the safety screen. Once you're happy, you can clear that. Next. In this instance, you need to select the Enable Auto Square. At this point, it will prompt you to make sure the bench is clear and to remove the extraction hose. So we're going to do that now before we proceed. I'll just remove the extraction hose. And then I can see that there's no obstructions on the top of the Y bench or in the channels on the upper X beam. So we're good to go. Once you're happy, you can press the home icon and the procedure will start. First, SmartBench will do its initial homing sequence. The auto squaring process will drive the X-beam into the legs and create a loud stalling noise. This is completely normal and nothing to worry about. After the machine is squared, SmartBench will rehome itself as it would have lost position during the squaring procedure. Once the procedure is finished, the Z head will illuminate green and the console will take you to the main lobby screen. You're now ready to start a job. So when should I home SmartBench? You'll need to home SmartBench every time you start it up or if the machine loses position. Instances when the machine might lose position are a power cycle, in the event of an alarm, in the event of an access stall, or if an access is knocked out of position by the operator. You can rehome SmartBench at any time by pressing the home button in the top right corner of the Pro app on the console. It's important to note that due to environmental changes and manufacturing tolerances, SmartBench's home position, and therefore its coordinate system, may vary slightly between homing cycles. If you're doing precision work, which includes multiple stages, such as tool changes, we recommend that you don't rehome between stages to avoid the homing tolerance having an effect on your job. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video informative and now have a better understanding of how to home and square with SmartBench.